Hi there. Let's learn how to use drop areas to create e-learning quizzes. A drop area object gives you a drop area where you can drag objects in. It's suitable for creating drag and drop interactions. To insert a drop area, open the Interactions tab and click Drop Area. Then, you will see the default drop appear like this. It includes four default elements: a drop area, a drag source, a correct message, and an incorrect message. You can customize these elements and add as many drag sources as you want. As you can see, an object as a drag source has a light green marker. Meanwhile, an object as a drop area has a light red marker. This marker doesn't appear in any output format but the editor. There's an orange drag-drop connector, which connects drag source with the drop area. This connector denotes that dropping the drag source to the drop area is a correct action. For this reason, it appears only when you drag the drag source to the drop area. You can use this default drag source, or convert other objects into the drag sources. To do that, select Objects, and go to the Drag and Drop section of the Properties pane, select Drag Source. ActivePresenter allows you to define some more properties of the drag source from here. You can specify a type of effect for selected drag sources. The effect appears when learners drag them. For example, with the zoom effect, the drag source will be zoomed out when learners drag it. In addition, you can define whether selected drag sources are sent back to their original positions when learners drop them outside the drop area. Because a drop area can accept multiple drag sources, you have to define which are the correct answers. To do that, click the drag source to show the marker, and drag it into the drop area. Then, the drag-drop connector appears. Alternatively, you can select the drop area and go to the Drag and Drop section of the Properties pane. Click this button to show the Accept List dialog. Select checkboxes in the Accept column to specify drag sources that can be dropped into the drop area. Added to that, if you allow learners to drag all drag sources into the drop area, click Accept All. The Correct column is meant for selecting drag sources as correct answers. The Drag Source column displays names of drag sources. Besides, to engage viewers better, you can specify the snap behavior, which is the properties of drag sources, after they are dropped into the drop area. The behavior properties include the size, opacity, position, and direction of the drag sources. To remove a drag source as a correct answer, click the drag-drop connector, and press the delete key. Or, you can right-click the drag-drop connector, and select delete. Now, you're free to use the score and reporting feature to control how the quiz should be played and reported. This is important especially when you want to track the result of learners using an LMS. However, we'll get to know it in details in the video, defining score and reporting of questions. ActivePresenter provides default events, actions for drop areas. But you're free to edit them the way you want. Remember that you can customize events, actions for both drag sources and the drop area from the Events, Actions section of the Properties pane. For example, I will add action pause presentation for onCorrect event. More information on events and actions can be found in the video, Working with Events, Actions. These feedback messages are added by default and ready to use. But you can add more or delete them as a normal object. Besides, you can change their styles or add events, actions to them. More information on this can be found in the video, Working with Feedback Messages. Now, let's see the result. That's all about using drop areas in ActivePresenter 7. Hope that helps. Thank you for watching.